whiskey lovers, and welcome to another one of Mark's Whiskey Ramblings. And today, I would like to talk to you about Strathairn. What? Never heard of Strathairn? Not to worry, not many people have, because this is a new distillery. It's a new distillery in the Highlands. It's probably the smallest, as they claim on their website, and they've only been in operation since 2013. So, of course, you haven't heard of them, because they have not yet got a single malt on the market. Unless you are fortunate enough to be part of the so-called private cask club. Because Strathairn has indeed enabled some clubs to enroll into this program, and then they can get their hands on a single cask, and this is one of them. A couple of these single casks have already been released, and this one, this cask 75, this private cask was bottled for the 10th anniversary of the Dutch Whiskey Association, our Dutch friends in Holland. And it was also the festival bottling of the Dutch Whiskey Festival, which was held in Arnhem in September 2018. So this is one of those. This is cask 75, and ooh, look at that color. And that's because this is a ex-sherry cask. And it is a whiskey that is produced from a non-peated spirit. Because it's Strathairn, they do both. You can have either peated, non-peated, bourbon cask, sherry cask, so there's a whole panoply of choices that you have there, and in this case, this selected cask was a non-peated Strathairn and a sherry cask, cask number 75, and this is bottled at cask strength and 56.6% ABV, and only 64 bottles were released of this goodie. So, a new Highland distillery. So this is quite young, because it's a private cask from 2014, meaning that this is only 3 years old, right? 56.6%, beautiful copper color, very bright, and it clings to the glass, revealing a medium to full body maybe, but it is still young, isn't it? Let's give this one a go on the nose. Well, it is clearly young, but it is pleasantly sweet on I get some sweet malt, an apricot marmalade, and some Haribo bears, you know, the little gummy bears, the candy. It is quite candy-like. There's also some figs and some raisins in there. So all these typical clear notes from a sherry cask intertwined with this young spirit. But quite lovely, in fact, on the palate. Wow. A very sturdy arrival. That's of course the ABV, but this is very powerful, quite feisty. I get lots of cloves, lots of cinnamon, some ginger, some licorice even, and then there's the fruit. And the fruit is again, it's quite citrusy on the one hand, and on the other hand I get some plums and some figs. It's quite spicy though, but quite fruity as well. A bit candy-like still, and even mid-palate. It turns a bit drying, I think. Let's see what this says on the finish. It remains sweet, a bit dark, a bit peppery, but drying indeed. It leaves your mouth completely dry. Wow, what a lovely surprise. I have to be honest, there's a lot of new distilleries popping up, you know, like mushrooms almost. I'm not entirely sure that all these beautiful projects will survive in the end, because, you know, there's only so much room for there's so much space, only so much space on the shelves for new brands. So I'm not sure all of them will survive. But to be honest, this Strathairn, quite lovely already. At the age of three, already this whole panoply of aromas and flavors is quite good. So I think this is one to look out for. I wonder what this will taste like when it's like 7, 8, maybe even 10 years old. Something to look out for. And that's it for this Whiskey Rambling, and I hope to see you at one of Mark's Whiskey Ramblings real soon. And until then, may the malt be with you.